In the previous class, we have seen Bt cotton and RNA interference. These two techniques are, one is gene addition, another one is gene subtraction. With the help of genetic engineering, production of recombinant forms, which are called genetically modified organisms or transgenic plants, which are naturally, they are being affected with various types of pathogens, whereas after the genetic exploitation, alteration of the genetic material and reincorporation of the altered rDNA, these plants become protective themselves, withstand to the effect of attack of the insects or pests. So the plant body itself has become a biopesticide or bioinsecticide, which are, it is a mechanism of defense RNA interference, whereas by the incorporation of a gene, a new gene into the normal plants, we are making them into transgenic plants to have more effective functions to fight against targeted pest or targeted insect. So in the RDNA technology of agriculture, now we are going to study about the impact of recombinant DNA technology in health or medicine. Recombinant DNA in medicine, health . So generally, what are these recombinant DNA technology, how it is used in the area of medicine? By production of recombinant DNA technology in the medicine, it has immense impact area of medicine by producing by producing large amounts of is called mass production. Fast and effective, more effective therapeutics means treatment of diseases which are called drugs, which are generally called recombinant drugs. So with the help of recombinant DNA technology, we are able to more accurate, more perfect and more effective therapeutics or drugs, which are called recombinant drugs, with which we can cure many of human diseases and disorders more effective, more perfect. Means what is meant by this more effective? Generally, the drugs developed by recombinant technology. Recombinant DNA technology. Does not produce or develop unwanted immune response. What is meant by unwanted immune response? For example, human beings are suffering with a genetic disorder, a disease, which is because of the improper production of insulin, proteinaceous hormone. The level of sugar in the blood increases because cells fail to take the glucose from the blood. So when the insulin is a hormone which controls the level of blood sugar, if it fails to produce in the body of human being, that person will be affected with a disease called diabetes mellitus, which is called sugar patient. And for this, what we are doing since times more than 100 years approximately after the discovery of this diabetes, whenever a person is affected with this disease or deficiency of insulin is found in his body, we are taking it from non-human sources. Non-human sources means not from the human body, other than human body, animal bodies like dogs, pigs, cows, cattle. So from the non-human sources or animal bodies, we are collecting this product, insulin, which is present in those animals by cutting their bodies, by getting their pancreatic fluids, and from there we are extracting this. And this insulin is injected into the human body periodically, whenever, in the form of small doses to control the level of insulin production in the body if the body fails to produce insulin itself. So when we are using a product, a drug like insulin from other animals, non-human sources, it can cause unwanted immune response. It means other animal's body is a foreign body, maybe like an antigen. Whenever a foreign body enters into the human body will show immune response, which is in the form of, it is exhibited in the form of symptoms, allergies or reactions, side effects, what we will call. So unwanted immune response means when human body is subjected to any product, any source from non-human, not from the human beings, from the other organisms, it will show unwanted immune response. But the same product, that is insulin, if we are able to produce in the laboratory with the help of recombinant DNA technology, if the same insulin is developed in the laboratory, which is called a recombinant drug or therapeutic drug, which is more effective, accurate, it is, why it is not going to produce any unwanted immune response. Recombinant DNA technology does, the drugs or therapeutics developed by recombinant DNA technology does not develop any unwanted immune response. Like, if we take the same type of drug from non-human, in the sentence, in that paragraph, first paragraph of recombinant DNA technology they have given, if we take the similar products as in the case of non-human sources, which can produce unwanted immune response, and with the help of recombinant DNA technology, presently in the world 30 different types of recombinant drugs are manufactured in world. Approximately 30 different types of therapeutic drugs, recombinant drugs. Have been developed and marketed among these approximately nearly 12 different types of these drugs are available in Indian market. In India 12 different types of these drugs which are called therapeutics for treatment are available. They are available, for example, very few human growth hormones, human growth hormones. They were responsible for increasing the height of the organisms, human beings who are shorter. By these, human somatostatins, we used to call the drugs that developed by recombinant does not any unwanted immune response, any side effect, any reaction, allergy. Gonadotropins. Interferons. Interleukins. Tissue plasminogen activator. TPA, streptokinase, anti-hemophilic factor 8, anti-hemophilic, HAEMOPHILIC, hemophilic factor 8, it is for the hemophilia patients. Tissue plasm for blood clotting, for cancers, for infertility, gonadotropins, penicillin, G. acylase, erythropoietins. Various types of vaccines like hepatitis B, herpes vaccine, rabies, meningitis, measles, influenza. So there are various types of vaccines and steroids. Etc. So many. So these are all, they were used, they were produced by recombinant DNA technology as a genetically modified drugs, recombinant drugs, and they were used for specific type of diseases or ailments of human being. So recombinant DNA technology is able to produce various types of vaccines, various types of steroids, various types of drugs. All these are for the betterment of human life, for the betterment of human life, which are more effective than compared to the other products produced from non-human resources, which are not developed by recombinant DNA technology. Now, to understand recombinant DNA technology, in the book they have given genetically engineered insulin. Production of genetically engineered insulin. They have given, what is insulin? First, insulin is a pancreatic hormone. Proteinaceous hormone. So make a note, if it is possible, it is not given in the textbook, they have mentioned 30 and 12 human growth hormones, gonadotropins, interferons, one or two missed. Interferons, interleukins, tissue plasminogen activators, anti-hemophilic factors, penicillin G acylase, erythropoietins, and vaccines, steroids. Vaccines for so many. Hepatitis B, hepatitis A, herpes, rabies, meningitis, measles, influenza. Now, what is this insulin? See, insulin in human body produced from beta cells of islets of Langerhans. It is to maintain sugar glucose levels in the blood. If any person show deficiency of this, of insulin, he is considered as diabetic patient, as affected with diabetes mellitus. Which is called sugar patient generally. So, it is a pancreatic hormone, it is a proteinaceous hormone. Insulin in human body produced from beta cells of islets of Langerhans. It is to maintain the glucose in the blood. If any person shows deficiency, so this will be imbalanced. He is not able to get insulin. So, the level of glucose increased in the blood. Why level of sugar increased in the blood? Because the cells of our body, that human's body, fails to take the glucose from the blood. So, the level of glucose increased in the body, why the cells fails to get the same glucose from the blood. So, he is considered sugar patient. So, periodically, such persons has to be treated by injecting insulin periodically, regular time intervals. Periodically means in the textbook they have given regular time intervals. The second paragraph, first or second sentence. At regular intervals, if the person who is affected with sugar is treated with insulin, the level will be maintained for some period, 1 or 2 months, 3 months, 5 months, 6 months. So based upon the doses, different. So to get insulin, it has to be collected from animals, non-human source. So, if a person is not having enough levels of insulin, he has to be administered, he has to be given the dosage of insulin regularly, periodically. Whenever, if he wants to take insulin, that insulin has to be taken from the animals, generally pigs or cows or dogs, various cattle. So here question comes, whether the insulin from animals is as effective as human insulin. First question. So first question is, we are taking insulin from the animal bodies, whether that insulin is similar to our insulin or not. It means how much effectively human body produce insulin and control the glucose in the blood, whether the animal insulin also will do the same function or not. Second question is, whether it produces any immunological response . So there are two questions in front of the human being for taking the insulin from other organisms. And the answer for this, whether the insulin from animal is as effective as, it is similar to human insulin. It can compensate the insulin, human insulin. But the second, whether it produces any immunological response, yes, it produces immunological response. In some human beings, it causes allergies. It causes allergies and various other reactions over a long period of usage. So, if a person who is affected with sugar patient or diabetes mellitus, if he has to be taken insulin from other animals, but for consumption for about few months or years, for long consumption, in the body of these human beings, unwanted immunological responses, which are called side effects, have been seen, like increased heartbeat leads to high blood pressure, short time but arrogance. So various types of the people who might have observed, old people who are having sugar patients by continuous usage of this, they are showing some symptoms like their angerness, a ferocious nature. Even though they were old, they are not going to, they will maintain on their word, which is called stubborn mental attitudes are seen. So even though it is having some effects, but it is
it is compensating the loss of human insulin. Now another thought, if we thought of if any bacteria is able to produce insulin, thought if any bacteria is able to produce insulin, very easy. Why? Because bacteria are easy to culture. Bacteria are easy. So how bacteria, we can grow bacteria in one day, millions of each bacteria consists of insulin protein, which is called single cell protein. In the coming topics we are going to study, if the gene for the insulin synthesis is extracted and incorporated into a bacterial cell with the help of vector plasmids, and if we culture clone of the gene and culture in the bioreactor, and if the gene expresses recombinant protein, recombinant drug, by downstream processing we are going to collect. So large scale production of useful products, large scale production of useful products which are more effective, less time, short period, accurate, more correct. It is easy to culture bacteria and large amounts of insulin can be produced in short period. So here the concept is, whenever a person is affected with diabetes or sugar in his body, the sugar level is increased in the blood. Why sugar level is increased in the blood? Because our cells are fails to take the sugar from the blood. That's why we are going to take insulin. Now question comes, whether insulin is administered orally. If insulin is given to a person, sugar patient, orally, yes or no, if it is taken or not? No, insulin cannot be administered or given to a patient orally. Why, sir? Because if we give insulin orally, it will be dissolved in the alimentary canal, no use. Why? Because it dissolves in the alimentary canal. It is of no use. So insulin cannot be administered orally, cannot be given to the patients orally. It has to be injected into the body. Now, sir, when a person is affected with sugar, a diabetic, how we are getting? In olden days, we are getting this insulin from the pancreas of slaughtered animals. That is pigs and cows, the first treatment. In 1916, first time diabetes observed as insulin deficiency. Sir Edward Sharpie Schaefer first person to identify that human beings are affected with insulin disorder. This is nothing but absence of insulin because of some gene is not able to produce this. In 1921, Banting and Best, two scientists, identified and extracted insulin from the drugs. Extracted insulin from dog's pancreas. Later, the sugar patients are so-called diabetic patients by slaughtered animals. Slaughtered means cutted, by slaughtered animal, from slaughtered animal bodies like pigs and cows. From slaughtered animal bodies like pigs and cows, insulin is extracted and given to human, which has adverse effects, harmful active effects on the humans. This has harmful effects. So even though it is having harmful effects, it is compulsory. There is no way second alternate in those days. Finally, they observed what this insulin is. My dear students, pancreatic hormone, proteinaceous hormone. So in bacteria is able to produce insulin, it is easy. So in bacteria, how to produce insulin? By recombinant DNA technology. If we take the insulin gene and incorporate in a vector into a Escherichia coli by transformation, by growing the Escherichia coli, we can get large amounts, mass production of recombinant proteins. Now let us see, what is this insulin? They have pancreatic hormone, proteinaceous hormone. Insulin is made up of two polypeptide chains called chain A and chain B. Chain A, polypeptide means protein. A protein is nothing but polypeptide. In a polypeptide, so many amino acids are present. We have studied already. A chain, chain A, has 21 amino acids. Chain B, it has 30 amino acids. Altogether, total 51 amino acids. So it is a smallest protein, a smallest short proteins with less number of amino acids. Now when they observed the insulin in human body, these two chains, chain A chain A chain B chain A consists of 21 amino acids, chain B consists of 30 amino acids. In between these two chains, there is a another chain, another structure, which is called chain C, approximately 30 amino acids. So this is the structure of insulin in the human body or any other mammal's body. This structure having disulfide bonds and some other disulfide bonds in A. So this total structure is called proinsulin, or like a prohormone. Prohormone. What is a prohormone? First formed. It is not mature. A prohormone or proinsulin has to be matured. How to mature it? By removing the C and by joining the A and B with disulfide bridges. So, in human body or mammals, insulin is produced in the form of proinsulin. In human body, in mammals, insulin is produced in the form of proinsulin, which has to be matured, which has to be processed to make it mature insulin. So, what is the difference between mature insulin and proinsulin? In proinsulin is having A chain, B chain with a C chain attaching the A and B. In between the A and B, C chain is there. But the challenge in front of the recombinant DNA technology is we have to produce insulin in mature forms. We have to produce insulin in mature. We don't need this C chain. Insulin in mature form. Is the challenge. Production of insulin in mature form, challenging task, which was made it possible by Eli Lilly Company of America in 1983. They have developed a recombinant human insulin, which is recombinant human insulin, a pure form in the name Humulin, and they marketed it. Humulin is a synthetically produced or recombinant, with the help of recombinant DNA technology, the recombinant drug, which is better than all other sources of insulin from any other non-human sources. Effective drug. And here, Humulin, how they have synthesized, sir? They have produced the chain A and chain B. Chain A sequences, amino acid sequences in the form of RNA, mRNA. So three letters is equal to one amino acid. Like that, A 21 amino acids they have produced. 21 into 3. They have produced RNA molecule with the help of reverse transcription by joining reverse transcription. How? With the help of a primer. They will take the help of a primer and they will make, with the help of this, synthesis of another by eliminating thymine, uracil in the place of thymine. We'll remove the uracil, thymine it will become from RNA to DNA, which is called reverse. Now we will remove this is called a gene. a DNA fragment which consists of a gene for 21 amino acids. Now they have incorporated this gene into the bacterial cells. So the gene for 21 amino acids, a chain incorporated into bacterial cells where it is synthesized. Next, they have developed another chain B chain with 30 amino acids, same process, reverse transcription gene for B into the E. coli cells, able to produce. Both are separately produced in the laboratory, chain A and chain B. After production of chain A and chain B, they have joined these with disulfide bridges. Disulfide bridges. Chain A 21, chain B 30, total 51 amino acids functional gene. This functional gene with 51 amino acids, third disulfide bridge is found in the A chain. Third disulfide bridge. So what is the challenge in the recombinant DNA technology in the company private sector? They have challenged to produce a recombinant insulin which is not taken from any organisms but produced in the bacteria, which are heterologous organisms, prokaryotic organisms. And prokaryotic organisms easy to culture, easy to produce large amounts in less period. So insulin, which is called Humulin, first produced by Eli Lilly company 1983, later GeneTech company, so many other companies. Presently various types of companies are there which are able to produce various types of insulins, different formulations, but they should have same. It is more effective. So here, when proinsulin is converting into mature insulin, the part C is removed by cutting with cyanogen bromide. Here, whenever new insulin, synthetic insulin, there is no need of these replacements. Directly, the mature insulin in mature form is injected into the patient periodically. Like that, we can control the diabetic mellitus disease, which is a genetic disorder. A particular gene for the production of insulin is mutated or changed or fails to express gene mutation. Now, we'll see in the next class, gene therapy. So my dear students, most important thing is, whenever you have taken care of listening the class with the help of, it is a painstaking work, I know that, for hours you have to sit in front of the mobile or in front of the systems or in front of the computer, something. So natural human tendency is, in the presence of a teacher inside the classroom, when students are in front of the teacher, it is difficult for a student who is having some negligence to listen the class, may not be able to listen properly even after the monitoring of teacher standing. And I'm having doubt that whether these classes are captured by you in the mobile properly or not. So we will see. Take care. Whenever you are listening the class, see the textbook NCERT along with the page numbers. Read it one time, two time, three times, because you are having ample time. Afternoon, we are not taking any classes. You can eat and sleep, and after some test, you can open the book, identify what we have given, taught, or next day it is then uploaded in the YouTube's, whatever we call media. You can see it, or you can call the principal sir or someone else here in the computer department to send that. They will send to proper number. The concept is, in the textbook, whatever is their content, whether it is correlated with the class or not, All the best.